Hey, it's Allison from computers.mom here to show you how to scan on a Mac. In just a few clicks, you can turn paper documents, photos, receipts into digital files on your computer. We're going to walk through the steps and you'll find a handy one-page summary at the end of this video. Many people assume, by the way, that they should start a scan by pressing the scan button on the printer. You can do it that way, but I find it's much easier to scan from the computer end, not the printer end. So to get started, on your Mac, open System Preferences. I have it right here on the dock, but if you don't see it, you can always find System Preferences on the Apple menu up here in the top left corner. That's two different and equally good ways to open the System Preferences window. You can use either one. In the System Preferences window, locate and open Printers and Scanners. On the left side of this window, you'll see a list of all the printers and scanners that have ever been connected to this computer. Two things to notice here. First, none of these devices are currently ready to use. We can tell because they all have red dots and say offline. Second, notice that when I select any one of these devices, some are just printers and some are multifunction, meaning they can print, copy, and scan. When I choose a printer in the list, if it's just a printer, the options will look something like this. But if it has scanning capabilities like this one, you'll see a scan option appear over here. So if your printer is all set up and connected and the power's on, you'll see it in this list with a green dot. So let's start scanning. Select the desired printer from the list on the left. Click the scan button on the right, and then click Open Scanner. A new window opens up with scanning options. Look for the Show Details button and click it if it's available for maximum control. Let's move this window up over the other one so it's a little easier to see. The Scanner Details view gives you a lot of options, so it can feel a little overwhelming, but the good news is that you don't usually need to change most of them. You can just leave the settings that are already there. But I want to start by pointing out one funny little quirk that trips people up all the time. See how Use Custom Size is checked right here? Right now, the scanner is expecting our document to be 0 inches by 0 inches. So if we scanned right now, the scanner would create nothing, but there wouldn't be any error message. I can't tell you how often people are flummoxed by this, so be sure that the size in the settings matches the size of the thing you're scanning. I'm going to scan regular letter size paper so I can uncheck custom size and use US letter, which is the first option that comes up. Okay, that's fixed, but I forgot to put my document on the scanner. Here it is. Now, on the left, I see a preview of my scan. The dotted line shows me the area that will be included in the scan. See how a little bit at the bottom will be cut off? That's okay, I don't need that. Now let's take a quick look at some of the options on the right. Most of them have blue drop-down arrows that let you select from a list of choices. First one, where is the document you're scanning? If it's face down on the scanner glass, flatbed is fine. But if you have and are using an automatic document feeder, make sure the scan mode is set to ADF. Next, decide if you want to scan in color or black and white or grayscale and how high the resolution should be. For an everyday document, 75 dots per inch is probably fine, but if you're scanning a photo or something where you need to see the fine details, you can bump up the resolution. Just keep in mind that higher resolution and color will make your scan files a lot bigger. If you accidentally loaded your document upside down or sideways, the orientation buttons here let you adjust for that. Next, decide where you want the scanned document to be saved. I often save scans to the desktop so they're easy to find, but let's change this to the Pictures folder just for practice. I can also choose a name for the document I'm saving. Let's call this one Scan. I know, not original. Finally, there's one last setting that's quite important. The format. If I open the format options list, you'll see a long list of choices, but it's easier than it looks. In the vast majority of cases, you're only going to use JPEG for images or PDF for documents. Since we're scanning a document, let's save it to the desktop after all, not the pictures folder, and make the format a PDF. Notice that when I switch the format from JPEG to PDF, I get an additional checkbox. Combine into a single document. If you are scanning a document that is multiple pages, checking that box tells the scanner to combine all the pages into a single file. Once the options are set the way you want them, click the scan button to get things moving. Your scanner makes its grrrr noise, and when it's finished, we can close the scanner window and zoom out to find our document right on the desktop as we specified. Open it up if you want to check that it looks okay, and you're done. Once you know how, it's really not difficult, but it is a bunch of little steps, so here's a quick recap of the scanning process. Open System Preferences either from the dock or from the Apple menu. In the System Preferences window, open Printers and Scanners. In the left side of the window, select your printer and make sure it has a green dot. Click Scan on the right-hand side and then click Open Scanner. In the Scanner window, choose the appropriate options for your scan: the format, the size, the location, the name, and so on. But if you don't see all the options you need, be sure to click the Show Details button. And finally, click Scan to make it so. That's it. Thank you for watching. Please click like if you found this helpful. We invite you to post comments and questions below and subscribe for more Computers.Mom videos.